Denning with Nick Jensen, 2-on-1 against Moore. Glendenning's shot, saved by Rask. That's a gigantic save.
How's it going, everybody? Welcome to another week of Coach Schnoes Segments. This week, we're going to take a look at a couple of 2-on-1s against Tuukka Rask of the Boston Bruins while talking about our job in these situations and how we can improve our own play on 2-on-1s. On a 2-on-1, a goalie's most important job is to take away the shot. If you look at this play, Tuukka Rask does a great job by getting way out of his crease to make Dylan Larkin look for a pass all the way down the ice here. The problem for Larkin is that Torrey Krug is doing a great job of taking away his option to pass it to Luke Glendenning behind him. In this situation, I see a lot of younger goalies that tend to back up and cheat the pass across, even when their defenseman's taking that pass away. See how far Rask stays out this entire time? That makes making the save much, much easier for him in this situation. Rask ends up playing this situation a little bit flat because up until this point, it looks like Dylan Larkin is going to pass this puck. So, in order to make sure that he could cover a potential soft pass into that backdoor area where Glendenning could slide, Rask is being a little bit flat in his net. Regardless, he's able to make a really nice save when Larkin does shoot this puck. On this second 2-on-1, we once again see a shorthanded 2-on-1 for the Red Wings in this first period of a tie game. Very, very important situations for Tuukka Rask to come up big for his team. Now, once again, let's look at Tuukka's depth. He's very, very far out of his crease again. Once again, forcing Luke Glendenning to look for that shot, especially because of how this 2-on-1 sets up for the Red Wings. Looking from behind the net, we can see Rask is once again very aggressive out on top of his crease in this situation, really forcing Glendenning to look for that pass to Nick Jensen. But that pass has to go backwards because Jensen is so much higher up in this situation than Glendenning was on the 2-on-1 with Larkin. Now, Rask is set up in such a way that if that pass goes across, he can move a little bit flatter because of where that pass is going, moving across the top of his crease, instead of having to explode back towards his post like he would have in the first situation. This is also made easier by John Moore, his defenseman, once again taking away that pass in the slot. These two plays show the importance of communication between a goalie and their defenseman. The fact that these two defensemen know that they should be taking that pass away at all times makes it much easier for Rask to defend the shot on these odd man rushes. When the defenseman and goaltender know their roles so thoroughly on a 2-on-1, it makes it much easier for each person to do their job. I love seeing a goalie take on a 2-on-1 in this way, and it's something I want to see more goalies do. So, the next time you're at practice, talk to your defensemen and your forwards about playing situations like this. It'll be a huge step forward in helping you become a better goaltender.